I really waited for your turn on the ASAP stage last Sunday, and I was so happy to see you perform again. You were sorely missed as a dancer, and after that performance, you said you feel as if a part of you is alive again. Parang ang saya ng puso mo, no? Have you had a time to process this time of your life?
Well, as always, everything's not going according to plan. laging may ibang plano ang showbiz for me, ang buhay ko for me. And so actually, I'm just learning to let go and just really go with the flow. And also recognize all the good things that are happening in my life. Like what I said, after Provinciano, I thought I was going to rest. I even thought I was going to have a simple and quiet Christmas in the States with my sister. Pero iba, ang daming nangyari when I got out of the Provinciano bubble. When I got out of that, ano ba ang unang pumasok? Well, they were already asking, kailan ako ba pumasok sa stage? And actually, I have ASAP to thank for, you know, for not giving up on me. They kept on asking me, kailan ka babalik? Sabi mo, promise mo, pagkatapos mo maging police, magiging dancer ka na ulit. But then, I don't know, it made me realize, ah, wait, it's not like before anymore. Parang, I have to discipline myself and prepare myself. Hindi na siya kagaya ng kabataan ko because, Miguel, I started when I was 13. I started dancing on the ASAP stage. So, kumbaga parang minamaniko lang yun ng bata ako. But because I stopped for 8 years, parang I had to regain my strength, I had to regain my self-confidence, and yun nga, the preparations, I had to make talaga those preparations na hindi ko naman iniisip before, like yoga for my flexibility again, working out with my coach again for strength. Ito, this time around, kumbaga parang second wind siya. But this time around, I'm more focused, I'm more disciplined, and I'm definitely not going to take this for granted. So like what you said, nung nabasa mo yung sinabi ko na parang a part of me feels as if, you know, it's alive again. Totoo yun, because I had to give up on that dream. I had to give up on that. It wasn't even a dream. I was living the dream. That was my reality. You know, every Sunday I would go on the stage. It became a part of my life pala. Became a huge part of who I am as a person that I had to give up on.
Yes.
I had to stop it because I got diagnosed with hypothyroidism. And so
yes,
I was gaining weight but uncontrollably.
Yeah, so let's talk about that. So that aside from your triumph of coming back, this is also a triumph for your health, because hypothyroidism isn't a joke. You have to really take care of yourself to recover from that. So when you got diagnosed with that, was that the reason that you really had to step back from ASAP 8 years ago?
I got diagnosed more than 8 years ago.
Okay.
So parang it was parang and I did not handle it well. Syempre bata pa ako eh, and ako kasi yung tipo ng tao na I was never conscious about my body. Not like the generation now. You know that they're so aware with workout, with health, with, you know, their physique. Ako growing up, hindi talaga ako conscious na bata. So I was dancing on the ASAP stage, but I was not working out. So walang rehab na nangyayari sa katawan ko. And then I got diagnosed with that, and I did not think na time will come na masasabi ko na, okay, you know what, it can be cured, it can be, you know, it can be tamed, because it's all about hormonal imbalance. That's it, actually. And at a very young age, sobrang unusual yun. But then, you know, I've been working since I was 6. I've been buyat since I was 6 years old. And like what I said, I was not taking care of my body. I was not working out. I was not living a fit lifestyle. And also, may gimmick pa yon on the side. Tapos may taping ka pa. Tapos meron ka rin movie. Diba? I mean, youth. Diba? Hanggang sa siningil ako ng katawan ko. And so, I had to work on it. Like, people now, whenever they see me, they always tell me, boy, parang sobrang you lost weight. Because really, honestly, I think this is my thinnest. I'm at my pinaka-fit body, like, state now. So I always say, you know what? It did not happen overnight. Grabe yung sacrifices ko that I had to do. I had to work out every other day. I had to, for a while, nag-pescatarian ako for 4 years. Just to, you know, really get rid of yung chicken kasi marami talagang hormones yan eh. So I had to let go of that. And also the mental, you know, yung mental damage na nagawa sa akin. Kasi parang feel ko, okay, so pataba na lang ako ng pataba, hindi ko na ito makokontrol. Because I was having breakouts also na parang never ko naging problema. Mm-hmm. Those hormonal changes, sobra siyang naging evident sa buhay ko when I quit ASAP. And so sabi ko, ah, okay, sige po. Showbiz na lang ako, mag-artista na lang. But I guess this is also my way of telling people, especially yung mga na-diagnosed with hypothyroidism, it's not impossible to tame your hormones. You just have to be very disciplined. But here I am right now. I don't even remember being this grateful for a healthy and fit body. Kasi nga, I never kong inisip na makakasayaw ako ulit. Because I never thought I would, you know, get rid of that weight.
Because
it comes with us.
Yeah, and Shaina, you radiate yung gratitude na to. Because aside from you being fit and healthy, it translates to confidence. Nakitang-kita namin when you were in that neon dress on ASAP. You just radiated confidence, Shaina. I was so happy to see you really back in the element.
You know, kailan ko lang din na-realize na, well, since yung 25 years kasi na award, I mean, alam ko matagal na. Pero kapag ka nalagyan ng numero kasi parang, wow, okay, sige, 25 years na nga pala talaga. And that happened when I got out of the bubble na hindi ko rin in-expect because that award was a surprise. I did not know that I was getting that. And then, parang perfect timing din na nakapila na yung ASAP, nakaplano na yun. And parang, it actually made me realize na yung 25 years of my life in the industry, isang malaking aspeto na is dancing. It parang my being a dancer pala. And hindi ko siya nakita because it wasn't like as if na parang it felt like a loss nung nag-quit ako sa ASAP eh. Kasi I had other things to do. So parang okay, nawala yung pagsasayaw, but I had projects, I had acting stuff to deal with. Pero ito, parang it gives me a renewed perspective even with my being a dancer. Parang siyang renewal, galing. Kasi in line siya with my life, in line siya with my career, tapos in line din siya with my being a dancer. Mm-hmm. So everything that is happening right now, it's actually already a gift. It's already a bonus. It's not even part of the plan. But I'm so grateful na I have good people around. Isa na doon is yung Star Magic. Kasi lagi kong sinasabi, hindi kami magtatagal in the business. If it weren't for our handlers and our road managers. And that night, anim kami na nabinigyan ng award. But hundreds ang nakasuporta dun sa anim na yun.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why we lasted for 25 years. with ASAP na these people had faith in, I guess, my talent and my gift because I did not go through formal dancing classes. I was trained by my dance mentor, si Teacher Roselle, every single week.
Yeah.
So, I'm very fortunate that I have people like, yan, yung ASAP family ko na parang 13 years old, welcome nila ako, when I had to say goodbye, they accepted that. But, you know, they never lost hope in me. So now that I'm ready, they welcomed me with open arms. And, you know, it's parang very humbling lang na there are people like that in your life. And so, nag-uumapaw lang talaga ng gratitude. Buhay ko ngayon, because like what I said, for someone who's been, you know, trying to run away from show business,
Halika,
sobrang daming
Shaina.
Oh,
We
I
won't
mean,
let you go.
Wala eh. Talaga, okay, so maybe it's, you know, time for me to really accept my fate.
Yeah.
Also, you know, embrace this part of my life with open arms.
Yes, please. Yes,
yeah, just
please.
With it.
And will part of embracing that be seeing you more regularly on ASAP? What can we expect? Every Sunday ba? Every other Sunday?
Well, right now, per cycle. So, I think na naka-pandemic, ano pa rin. They do a parang a once-a-month cycle. So, I think that's equivalent to once a month. So, I've done December. Naka-schedule na rin ako for January. So, I'll be starting the year as the dancer, Shaina, again, that everyone knows. Ang
so, you really are back, no?
I'm back. I even can't believe that I'm back, but I am. Yes, mas regular, and actually this time around, I'm looking forward to trying it out once again. Kasi nga parang tagal kong napahinga.
So trying it out, genre shine. Anong shine? Anong kind of Shaina ang gusto mo ipakita in terms of genre naman?
Well, syempre na miss ko yung even know if kaya mo i-label na isang genre lang. But
okay.
Lumaki kasi ako sa ASAP na iba-ibang klase ng sayaw. Kung ano
yeah.
Yung latest.
Yeah.
So, siguro just really, and they lost that, kumbaga that yung type ng sayaw namin dati. Kasi nga parang naging ano na eh, iba na rin ang sayaw ng kabataan ngayon. So siguro maraming na kami, sabi nga nila parang nostalgic daw to see me dancing that way again. So siguro my biggest contribution would be parang okay, if you appreciate this, if it's what you miss, then sige, yun muna yung bibigay natin. But knowing ASAP kasi, they really stretch you. They really parang,
literally and figuratively.
Yes. Stretch talaga. So yes, the sky's the limit kapag ganun yung when you have the stage, when you have these people around you, like G-Force na, you know, they're not just dancers to me. They're my brothers and my sisters on the dance floor. Every single week, nakikita ko sila ng ilang taon. So, parang pati yun, renewed, you know, renewed environment, renewed friendships din kami. Kasi syempre, we lost touch na dahil ako na mas nag-concentrate ako bilang isang artista. But then their support and their confidence in me, it really remained. So kapag ka tinatanong ko ng teacher, kaya ko ba? Oo, kaya mo yan. So actually, vision niya ni Teacher Roselle.
Ang ganda.
Yung production number na yon, she was the one who suggested that that song. Yung Black Eyed Peas and Shakira Peas, siguro kasi parang nakikita niya talaga na parang okay, ito bagay sa'yo to. Siya rin yung nagsabi ko anong susuotin. You know, those things na ang tagal ko nang hindi nagawa. Ginawa ko ng buong-buo. And so, worth
and
it
with,
naman lahat ng bago.
And with much impact, no? Ang G-Force Shine will be your staple collaborators. Pero on ASAP, among the artists, na mainstay na matagal na and new ones, sinong mga gusto mong makasayawan? Because before you had Maha, Raver, and John, but they won't be around. Eh, sinong gusto mong makalaborate ngayon?
Everyone.
Everyone.
I mean, just to be able to be with everyone and be back on the ASAP stage, that's already an honor. And I guess yun nga, now that I'm more confident with my health also, and pinaghahandaan ko kada performance this time around, kahit ano sigurong i-challenge nila sa akin, the moment I said yes, kasi, you know, going back on the ASAP stage, yes na yan to all. So, kung ano man yung gusto nilang pagawa sa akin, yeah, of course, medyo ano lang ako, kasi diba before, if lumaki kayo sa ASAP, I'm very, parang active dun sa mga liftings and everything. This time, dalawang baby lift pa lang. Kasi nga introduction, like, oh my gosh, kaya ko pa ba yun?
Binuhat ka, di ba? Last Sunday?
Binuhat ako, but very light. Hindi pa yung kagaya natin. Tinatapon-tapon ako. But yeah, I think, well, now I'm still doing yoga. I'm still doing all the preps that I can do para when I step on the ASAP stage, ready yung katawan ko.
Kaya. You're at your healthiest anyway. Shine, kanina, you mentioned the Star Magic milestone, no? Sabi mo nga, pinarangalan kayo. And among them, Angelica, Dimples, yung mga kasabayan mo talaga. And kayo na yung tinitingala ngayon. Kayo na yung tinitingala ng mga bata dun sa Christmas gathering na yun. May napag-usapan ba kayo about that? Taking stock of being the ones who are being looked up to now by the newcomers.
Usapan, but I guess if you listen to our speeches, then kumbaga, baguhan ka, then marami kang mapupulot dun sa mga advice na mga ate at mga kuya na nagsalita natin. Ako ay the only thing na gusto kong sabihin at lagi kong sinasabi, na hindi ko nasabi that night dahil sobrang ako na-overwhelmed, talaga parang surprise siya. Wala naman akong kapagmamayabang na, you know, na I'm the best in this, I'm the best in that. Because I really believe na lahat tayo we're talented in our own ways. Diba? Baka, you know, given the perfect opportunity, mas magaling pa sila. I mean, lahat tayo gifted, lahat tayo talented. But for you to last in this industry, you really have to be and dapat marunong kang makisama sa mga tao. Kasi kahit na anong galing mo, kapag hindi ka na ginustong katrabaho ng mga katrabaho, wala ka na makukuha ang trabaho. So you just really parang make sure na you always have something new to offer, especially for someone like kami na medyo industry, na you know, you should never stop learning, you should never stop evolving. Just like in life, di ba? You get to learn so many things. Nadadapa ka, but make sure na kaya mo rin, na itatayo mo pa rin yun, ang sarili mo. So yun. So, hindi ko masasabi that I'm the best here, I'm the best there, pero I take pride in my professionalism.
Na to the point na talagang kinukulit ka ng ASAP na bumalik, ibig sabihin gusto ka nila makatrabaho ulit. A testament to your professionalism.
I try my best. Really, it's ano siya, switch ng mindset. Kasi not everything is perfect. Not everything is easy. This world can be very chaotic, you know, show business. But really, you just have to be humble and always just choose to find the good in every person, in everything that's happening, no matter how challenging the season is, there's always something good to look forward to. There's always some good person or there's always something good that's happening. You just have to see it. You just have to choose to see it. And ako, siguro at this point in my life, I can choose to be tired. I can choose to say, okay, I've had enough. I can choose to say, next, ayoko na. But, you know, I'm recognizing all the good in my life. People, experiences, opportunities, lahat yun. I'm there right now.
So that's on the aspect of being professional, Shine, and being grateful for the opportunities that come your way. Pero ano yung pwede mong i-advise sa mga newcomers when it comes to being a public figure? Because you've been like 25 years, open book na ang buhay mo, minsan inuusisa, di ba? Because you're an actress, you're followed widely by a lot of Filipinos. Ano yung pwede mong sabihin sa kanila to handle the pressure of being seen always?
You know, it's never too easy. it's never normal na lagi may masasabi yung mga tao around. But then, it comes with your job. Right? But I guess, natuto na lang din kasi ako to actually accept that fact na may masabi, may magawa ako, may masasabi, may hindi ako gawin, may masasabi pa rin. So, what those things, those people are beyond my control. What's something I can control? It's just myself and how I am towards the people around me, meaning my intentions. And so, as long as, you know, I can sleep well at night, and like now, like with every single person that, I get to speak with, I get to meet, I get to work with, I want to make sure na maayos at mabuti yung intentions ko. And that's what matters most. So kung may masasabi pa rin sila, well, at least I put out something sincere and something good. And so I can carry on with that. So yeah, I think when I was younger, lahat ng masasabi ng mga ibang tao would, you know, still get to me, or para, you know, put me in a bad mood, or para it affects my mental state and everything. Pero siguro it also comes with security, like self, and also because I have good people around me na alam ko kilala ako and kung sino talaga ako. That's why it doesn't bother me any. I mean, tao ka pa rin at the end of the day. Pero for it to define you, just like when I was younger, hindi na, it will never define me.
So you are equipped, Shine, to go on for another 5, 10, 25 years, you think?
Wherever I'm needed, really.
Okay.
And that's also how I'm seeing my calling of service. And alam niyo naman yan, I talked about that.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm seeing my job in a different way now. Parang whenever a director says na kailangan kita dito because I feel that you're the perfect fit for this role, then that it would be my pleasure to, you know, to serve him by doing my best. So wherever and whenever I'm needed, ayoko namang ipagdamot kung ano man yung bine-bless sa akin ni Lord. So I'm here to, you know, I'm here to be an instrument in my own little way, and hopefully it's working, and it seems like it's working kasi 25 years na yung ko. So yeah, at this point, since wala sa mga plano ko yung nasusunod, I'm just here, wherever, whenever I'm needed.
Yeah.